Thanks, Gay. Throughout the month, Daybreak has been showcasing local musicians in our open mic series, and sadly, today that comes to an end with our final musician of the month.
Yes, it is very sad, but we are happy to welcome Jamie Cedars. He is from Mason City, and he...
Well, now that the shutdown is over, Minnesota state leaders have a big task ahead of them, getting things up and running once more, and residents are being asked to be patient during the process. State offices like the DMV are weeks behind on mail, licenses, and permit applications. It could take a month to get caught up. Also, the state lost millions of dollars in the shutdown, including revenue from lottery sales, tax audits, and state park fees, not to mention the money spent preparing to shut down the state, as well as the cost of unemployment and health benefits for laid-off workers. The full amount is expected to be released in the coming weeks. The State Patrol is also looking into whether seatbelts were worn at the time of the crash. A Roseville, Minnesota native is being remembered by his friends and family. Sean Maddie went missing a week ago Sunday while swimming with friends in Indiana. His body was found 2 days later about 20 yards from shore. Preliminary autopsy results show Maddie died of an accidental drowning.
I never had an older brother and I'll always be there for you.
More than 500 people came to Maddie's hometown to support his family. Maddie also went on to play Big Ten football at Purdue University after high school. Plans for the Minnesota Vikings to hold training camp in a southern Minnesota city are still up in the air. For the last 45 years, the Vikings have traveled to Mankato to prepare for the upcoming season, but this year they've delayed making the move because of the uncertainty with the NFL lockout. If the team doesn't practice in Mankato, it could be a serious blow to local businesses. If the lockout ends soon, the team has said they will make the trip, but if it continues, all preseason training would likely be held at Winter Park in Eden Prairie. One of Minnesota's U.S. senators is weighing in on the current shutdown situation. Democrat Al Franken says the shutdown couldn't come at a worse time. Summer tourism is a big revenue generator for the state, and he says Minnesota is losing money each day. Senator Franken adds that a mix of spending cuts and revenue increases are needed.
For people to come, the better.
Franken says it's especially important to get the 22,000 laid-off state employees back to work. Well, today officials are traveling through several Minnesota counties affected by recent storms to assess the damage. The Minnesota Homeland Security and Emergency Management will assess damage to public infrastructure and public buildings. They're looking for damage caused by storms throughout the state between July 1st and July 10th. On Sunday, Governor Mark Dayton declared a state of emergency in 16 Minnesota counties following severe weather on July 1st.
Well, it's a good day to, you know, be inside, maybe volunteer, perhaps do an indoor volunteer activity. Well, earlier this week, we were able to get a firsthand look at some of the work that Habitat for Humanity of North Central Iowa does on a daily basis.
Yeah, we had heard a little bit about some of the things volunteers do for the organization. So, hey, you know, we decided to head out there and give it a try for ourselves. And, you know, maybe we didn't do things perfectly, but we did have a pretty good time.
It was a really good time. Now, our clothes may be a little dirtier.
Well, a special segment will soon be debuting on KIMT. PGA professional Matt Messenger is working with a golf beginner and teaching her all the basics, and you'll get an in-depth look at the lessons each week for the next few months. It's called On the Tee, and Matt is here with us this morning. Good morning, Matt.
Good morning.
So what exactly will our viewers be able to see during these segments?
Well, we've got one of our ins and outs there.
And how beneficial will it be for beginners, even those who have maybe been playing a while, to get a look at some of these lessons?
Well, you know, hopefully.
Okay, so now the first episode starting Monday. Now we're starting from the very beginning before we even line up and hit the ball, right?
Oh, that's correct. You know, she's such a blend.
Okay. Now you have 11 weeks of lessons planned here over the next few months. Each, all golfers will be able to pick up something different and learn something for each week?
Well, yeah. You know, we cover something.
All right, so starting this Monday, every Monday through Friday at 7:10 a.m. on My Morning News, which is my 3.2. And Matt will also join us every Friday. So you're going to be getting comfortable
yep,
welcoming
yep.
in. Every week. I do have one serious question, though. Tiger Woods, how do you think he played yesterday?
I think everybody kind of saw his.
Yeah, it's fun. All right, sounds good. Sarah actually got a training lesson with you, too, and she said it went pretty well yesterday.
You know, she's coachable.
Great way to put it. All right, so once again, 7:10, Monday through Friday, My Morning News. Don't miss it. Well, when you hear ghost stories about a location, it's easy to brush them off and not believe them. But when you have to enter that building in the darkness and after midnight, well, it's just a whole different story. Joining me once again for this investigation is the local ghost hunting group, First Person Ghost Hunters. And again, everything you hear and see in this story is real. Now, the moan that you heard was caught on one of our video cameras as we investigated an upstairs bedroom. The unknown voice was picked up by one of the group's voice recorders. I can guarantee you both sounds were not made by humans. It was completely silent as we were investigating and when they were recorded. So once again, it's up to you to decide, is there an explanation or is it a clear sign of the paranormal? Jenna?
You're a brave guy, Tyler.
A southern Minnesota student is dead. Now a man is under arrest, accused of stabbing her and leaving her body in a ditch. 19-year-old Jocelyn Bishop's body was found by a truck driver on Friday in Mankato. 19-year-old Damone Christopher Williams Tillman, who goes by Chris Tillman, was arrested on Saturday in his Golden Valley home and brought back to Mankato. He's being charged with second-degree intentional murder. At first, the woman's body couldn't be identified until her coworkers reported her missing.
The moment we got that call, the motion.
Police say Tillman and Bishop did have a previous relationship.